morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship here at North Waseca Lutheran Church. It is good to be here together. Today we have Pastor Emily Carson here with us. She works in the Synod office, and would you like to introduce yourself and tell us a bit about who you are and what you do for the Synod?
Sure.
Thank you, Pastor Sarah. Hi, North Waseca.
Hi.
Wonderful to be with you this morning. As Pastor Sarah said, my name is Pastor Emily Carson, and I serve as a member of your Synod staff. I'm one of the assistants to Bishop Regina Hasnally, and the special focus of my role is supporting what the Holy Spirit is up to in congregations. For example, Young at Heart, and getting to celebrate and rejoice with you in this ministry. I also work closely with stewardship and working with councils and committees. So it's really good to be with you. I've been here to Pulpit Supply years ago, and it's good to be back and see what God is up to in your midst today.
I invite you to stand as we begin our worship with a time of confession and forgiveness. I invite you to take a deep breath. In the name of God, the Creator, Savior, and Spirit, amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. I invite you to repeat after me. Dear God,
we are sorry
for our thoughts, words, and actions. That did not show love toward ourselves or others. Forgive us. Help us start fresh on this new day. So that we can love you.
Love ourselves.
And love others. Freely and without limit. The way you do. We ask this in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
God knows that we are not perfect, that loving people is really hard for us sometimes, and that we are bound to make mistakes. And yet, God loves us fully and completely, every single moment of every day. Today is a new day, and we too are made new. In the name of Jesus, all our sins are forgiven. Amen.
Amen.
We sing together our opening song, God is Here. I'm going to take a second to teach you the chorus. Give me one moment. Goes like this. Repeat after me. God is here. God is here. God is here. God is here. God is here all around us with feet on the ground. God is here all around us with feet on the ground and calls to us now. And calls to us now. God is here, God is here, God is here, God is here. And we lift all our voices to sing of God's love. And we lift all our voices to sing of God's love. We know God is here. God is here. We know God is here. God is here. Shepherd your people, faithfully feeding and protecting us. Help us to care for ourselves and for our communities so that we may continue to be Christ to one another. Amen. You may be seated. We are going to read the psalm together. And we're going to learn the first verse together. How's that sound? Repeat after me. The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not be in want.
I shall not be in want.
The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not be in want.
I shall not be in want.
Okay, we're going to take turns reading the psalm together, and at the end, we're going to say that first line all together again. So I will read, you'll read the bold parts. There we go. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want.
The Lord makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside still waters.
You restore my soul, O Lord, and guide me along right pathways for your name's sake.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup is running over.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not be in want.
Our gospel reading for today is from the sixth chapter of the Gospel of Mark. And our theme for the sermon portion, the story time portion of today, is rest. So I invite everybody to be listening, especially for the word rest in this gospel reading for today. The apostles gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. And Jesus said to them, "Come away to a deserted place, all by yourselves, and rest a while. For many were coming and going, and they had no leisure even to eat. And they went away in the boat to a deserted place by themselves. Now many saw them going and recognized them, and they hurried there on foot from all the towns and arrived ahead of them. As he went ashore, Jesus saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them because they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. When they had crossed over, they came to land at Gennesaret and moored the boat. When they got out of the boat, people at once recognized him and rushed about that whole region and began to bring the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages or cities or farms, they laid the sick in the marketplaces and begged him that they might touch even the fringe of his cloak. And all who touched it were healed." Here ends our gospel reading. Rest matters. So I wonder, how do you feel when you're really tired? And this is a question for everybody to think about. There's different kinds of tired. Sometimes our brains get really tired. Sometimes our bodies get really tired. And sometimes our spirits are tired. So let's start first with our brains. How do you know your brain is starting to feel really tired? I'd love to hear from you. How do you know?
Can't think straight.
Can't think straight. Yes, thanks for getting us started. Good. How else do you know your brain's getting a little bit tired?
Get ornery, cranky.
Ornery and cranky. Can anybody identify with that? I can. Yes, absolutely. My brain's getting tired. I'm getting a little grouchier. What else? How else do, and it's different for all of us. Our brains and our bodies are each unique. How do you know that your brain's getting tired?
I get a headache.
headache. Anybody else get headaches sometimes? Yeah. How about when our bodies are getting physically tired? Maybe I just got to spend part of a recent weekend with my nephew and niece. Athena is 4 and Leander is 1. And we did so much playing in the sun. We went to a county fair yesterday in Iowa, the Wright County Fair, and we were sweaty and we were just physically tired. And Athena said, "I tired." wanted to take a nice long nap. How do you know that your body is tired? How does your body feel when it's tired?
It hurts.
It hurts. Sometimes the aches and pains show up a little bit more when we're tired. Yeah. What else? Yeah.
Weak.
Yeah.
Dehydrated.
Right. Good. Yeah, these are all signs that our body gives us that we need rest. And sometimes we're spiritually tired or emotionally tired. Sometimes we find ourselves in the midst of situations, maybe in our family, maybe in our workplace, that are really take a lot of emotional energy, and we get tired. And this gospel reading is really a special one from the Gospel of Mark, in which Jesus specifically encourages his closest, dearest friends to take rest. So at this point in Mark's gospel, Mark chapter 6, something really important had just taken place. Jesus' closest friends are his disciples, and he had shared with those disciples a special assignment. They had been invited to go out and share the good news and heal. The disciples had been very busy. They had been out and about in communities and neighborhoods. They had been healing and preaching and teaching, and they had just come back to Jesus, and they were like, "Jesus, you're not going to believe the kind of things we saw and heard. We didn't even have time to eat." Have you ever had a day like that? Raise your hand if you've ever had a day where you were so busy that you forgot to eat. How did you feel on that day? Tired, probably extra tired. So that's what had happened to the disciples. They were going and going. The lines were so long. All these people needed help. And Jesus said to his friends, "You're doing great, beautiful things. And also, it's really important now that you go to a quiet place and take some rest." Rest has different components. And Jesus encouraged his dearest friends not only to take time away, to step away, he also wants them to recharge, to refuel their tank. Have you ever, whether maybe you were a kid in the car or maybe you were the grown-up in the car, have you ever let your gas gauge get really close to E? Like right now, I have about 40 miles until empty. When the gas gauge is getting really close to E, what do we need to do? We got to go get gas. We got to refuel. And that's the case for human bodies, too. Sometimes we're getting really close to E, and our bodies and our brains give us different signals. Sometimes we're maybe a little ornery. Sometimes we're just physically weak and tired. And Jesus encourages us to pay attention to our bodies and our brains and take rest. And where we do that refueling is unique to each of us. We have different places that help us to refuel. Does anybody enjoy spending time by the water? Yeah. What's your favorite water to be near? Is there a special lake or an ocean or a place that you like to go that's close to water? How about you? Yeah, very good. Does anybody like to play in a sprinkler? That kind of water? Yeah, me too. Does anybody like to spend time in the dirt of a garden? That's my favorite place to find some rest and recharge. Where else do you like to recharge? Where do you rest and play?
Cozumel.
It has a little bit of everything, doesn't it? Bright blue sky.
Beautiful water.
Catamarans. Yeah, and you can probably just feel your gas tank filling back up, right? Yes. Yeah. And that feels good. It feels good to refuel. And how beautiful that Jesus has given us this instruction. Refuel. Recharge. That niece, Athena, had said, "I want to help you with your sermon." But also we were just playing and reflecting on the fun we had had at this place called Lake Clarion, which is 1 hour, they live in Des Moines, 1 hour north of Des Moines, and about 2 hours south for my husband and I, who live in Rochester. And so we were sitting on the dock, and before we were going to do any sermon preparation, we were just going to do a little practicing of our letters. She's learning her letters. And so I said, what should we practice writing? And she said, how about I love the lake? So she did help me with my sermon preparation. Because a four-year-old body knows how to recharge and how to rest. And for Athena, she likes to spend time by the lake. Where do you like to spend some free time? Do you like water too? Yeah. How about you? Yeah. Yeah. Me too. So Athena loves the lake. I love the garden. You love Cozumel. Today I encourage each of you to give yourself a moment to consider, where do you feel rest? Where do you feel recharged? And I also encourage you to remember that this is part of what it means to be a human being, a follower of Jesus, is to give ourselves permission to rest. It's a really important part of how we follow Jesus, is serving and loving and being community in Jesus' name, and also taking time to refuel and recharge. So I give thanks for each of you and the ways that you are uniquely made. May you know and believe and trust that you are a beloved child of God, and in the days and weeks ahead, please do give yourself permission to rest and to recharge. Amen.
Try to be like Jesus. May that include rest, to rest like Jesus. We are going to sing our song of the day, which is called Live Christ. It's been a minute since we've done this one, so repeat after me. Live Christ, love Christ. Live Christ, love Christ, share Christ, be Christ, share Christ, be Christ. All these things do today, all these things do today. All these things along your way, all these things along your way. And then we're going to replace the word Christ with the words peace, hope, and love in each verse. So we'll say live peace, love peace, share peace, be peace. I invite you to stand as we sing.
All these things.
Sticky notes. I invite you to take a moment and write or draw your prayers on your sticky notes, and then we will have some helpers bring them forward, and we will pray for them all together. You may be seated as you write. Take some time. Write or draw your prayers for the world, for the people you love. And then we will pray together. Forgot to mention that if you have any prayers that you would like to remain unspoken, you can also send forward a blank sticky note and we'll pray for those too. Carry our prayer board around or stick sticky notes on it. You're going to help out?
All right. We're going to come around if you'd like to collect our stickies.
Right.
lead in prayers?
Sure.
Just take turns.
Yeah.
Let us pray together. Good and gracious God, we thank you for this time to be here together and to pray for one another. We pray, I'm just going to take them off the board as we go. We pray for love and hope and for all people who are traveling.
We pray for peace and harmony in the world and for people who have suffered from strokes.
We pray for all who have suffered loss due to the flooding, for all of the homes and crops and belongings.
We pray for children, for all of the children, and for the children of this congregation.
We pray for health.
We pray for family and for our church family.
We pray for Nina, that you would give her comfort. And we pray in thanksgiving for a lovely family.
Compassionate God, we pray for Aunt Diane and for all who are living with dementia.
We pray for farmers and homeowners and all who are recovering from floods.
We pray for Hallie on her upcoming trip and for gardens everywhere and for crops.
We pray for the healing and peace of all who are suffering with illness, that your presence may be known to them.
Compassionate, gracious God who hears our prayers, we pray specifically for corn and for beans that are growing in the fields that they might grow strong. We pray, God, for the right amount of rain, that rain would stop so that fields could dry out. And also, gracious God, for an end to flooding.
We thank you, God, for the opportunity to be here together today. And we pray for all who are unable to be with us today.
We pray a prayer of gratitude today for all that God is doing here in this place through the people of North Wasika Lutheran Church.
We pray for peace and for harmony in this world. Where there is broken, make us whole.
Compassionate God, we pray today that in this week ahead, there might be sunshine. And that when the sun is shining, we will remember to experience gratitude for it.
We pray for our children and our grandchildren's, for our grandchildren, for our spouses, the people that we love most, and all who are on our hearts.
God, who hears us, we pray for our family and our friends, for healing for all those who need it. Again, gracious God, for peace in our world, and that we would be vessels of peace, and for all who have experienced flooding.
God, you know what is in our hearts, what weighs on our minds and our souls. We ask you to be present in those places where we need you the most. It is your name, in your name, that we lift these and all of our prayers to you, knowing that you hear us. In your name we pray. Amen. Peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
I invite you to share a sign of peace with one another.
offering today? Come on forward.
To stand as we pray. You can repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for giving us everything we need.
Help us to use these gifts
to love and to serve others
so that all may know
the goodness we have received. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may
may be seated. A few announcements before we conclude our worship this morning. We have treats downstairs after worship today, so stick around and hang out with us for a little while. We have a school supply drive in progress for Waseca Intermediate School, and there is a bag in the overflow room, the whatever we call that room in the back, available for any supplies you have. There are some extra supply lists on the table just inside the door and printed in the newsletter. And you can bring donations anytime before next Sunday or on next Sunday. That was a supply drive that was specifically requested by Waseca Intermediate School. And we usually do a general supply drive that we split between all of the different schools in our districts. And so stay tuned for another supply drive coming closer to fall. But for now, this one is specifically for Waseca Intermediate School. Save the date, August 18th, is going to be worship at the lake at Dan Jensen and Mary Cornelius' home on the lake. That will be at 8:45 on Sunday morning. So make note of it. Plan to be there. It will be a good time if we don't get rained out for the third year in a row. I'm saying that so that it doesn't happen. Are there any other announcements that I am missing? Any milestones to share this morning? The big, the small, the in-between things that we want to celebrate together in community.
The sun is shining through our stained glass windows.
The sun is shining through our stained glass windows. A milestone. Sure.
Pastor, we're going to celebrate you for 2 years. We love you.
Thank you.
We appreciate your inspiration, your guidance, your heart service, and all the things you do for us. The flowers are yours, and in honor of a little gardening, try some tomatoes and some jam that our granddaughter made, because you can make your own. All right.
Thank you. Thank you. It is my two-year anniversary with you all this week, so thank you to Cheryl and the council and whoever was involved in that gift. I have loved being here with you. You are a gift to me. A milestone. Any other milestones to share today? And I'm going to transition us into a milestone of another kind. Tally, you want to come up here? So Hallie, this week, is heading to New Orleans for the ELCA Youth Gathering. She's attending with Grace Lutheran in Waseca and joining their group. And so today we are going to send Hallie off with a blessing and with prayers for her and her whole group. And this commissioning is what the rest of her group is doing over at Grace right now, too. And so, at one point, I will ask you a question, and you're going to answer. We will, and we ask God to help us, and I'm going to prompt you when it's your turn. Right. Hallie, claimed by God, crafted with your own authentic gifts, step up one. My microphone always freaks out under speaker. Crafted with your own authentic gifts, you are a brave community of disrupted disciples called to be a participant in the 2024 ELCA Youth Gathering. In this, there will be times when you and your group feel energized and times when you feel exhausted. Times when you enjoy every activity that is planned, and times that you will wish that you were in charge. Times when the Holy Spirit will show up in joy, and times when the Holy Spirit will show up in challenge. And so I ask you, will you use your braveness for the sake of the gospel as you step into the journey ahead? If so, respond, I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you use your authenticity to enrich the gathering and the community of New Orleans? Will you freely participate in the gathering and with the people of New Orleans with the love and compassion of Jesus? Will you seek to disrupt injustice, working together in solidarity for the sake of your neighbors? Will you be respectful, curious, helpful, open, and kind? And now I ask the congregation, will you, led by the Holy Spirit, pray for Hallie and for the rest of her group in your daily prayers, asking for God's guidance, love, safety, and blessing in all of their endeavors? And upon their return, will you receive her and the rest of her companions, receive all of their stories and experiences with love and openness? If so, please say, we will, and we ask God to help us.
We will, and we ask God to help us.
Almighty God, bless you and keep you. Amen, and thanks be to God. A round of applause for Hallie. We look forward to hearing your stories when you return safely to us. And now I invite us all to stand as we receive God's blessing. The blessing of God who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us be upon you now and forever. Amen. We sing our sending song. Before I grab my guitar, I'm going to teach you the actions again. It goes like this. Repeat after me. I've got peace like a river. 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 I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. And then I'm going to shout, because Jesus, 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 Jesus is the joy in my soul, Jesus is the joy in my soul, in my soul. That's a pun. And then we repeat the I've got peace like a river again. The other verses go, I've got joy like a fountain. You can do it with me. I've got joy like a fountain. And I've got love like an ocean. I've got love like an ocean. In the last verse, we're going to put them together, and we're going to go, I've got peace like a river, I've got joy like a fountain, I've got love like an ocean, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. I know. I believe in you. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. Because Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. My soul. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain. I've got joy like a fountain, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got joy like a fountain.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Out of her garden.
Yes, she's. I think she's very upset.
Yes, Pastor. So grateful you're here.
Yes.
So grateful to be here. It's wonderful.
I almost stood up and turned and said, let's give her a standing ovation, but I know how much these people don't like to go off script. They're very conservative types, you know? Like, what? Oh, wait, no, Pastor didn't tell us to stand up and clap. I don't want to do that.
Little girl. No, nope, we're going to put them someplace else. Pick them up. That's just for noisy offering. We put them out there, but then they go back here in this room. Yeah.